Good morning, children. This is our next class of English language. We are going to start with our third chapter of English language. We have already completed kinds of sentences and we've also completed subject and predicate. This chapter is formation of interrogatives. I've already explained it to you very clearly what is an interrogative sentence. So formation of interrogatives means that how to form an interrogative sentence. So in this chapter we're going to learn this. This is something which you all have already studied in class 5, so it should not be a problem. This is comparatively a very easy chapter for you all. I'll explain that to you step by step and I'm sure that you people will be able to get a hang of it very easily. Let's start. So over here, I have just taken a slide from the previous chapter that I've done with you, where it says different kinds of sentences. There are four kinds: declarative, imperative, interrogative and exclamatory. Declarative and imperative end with a full stop. Exclamatory ends with an exclamation mark. Interrogative ends with a question mark. You already know what these kinds are. So formation of interrogative. So from any of the three other kinds, from a declarative or from an exclamatory sentence or from an imperative sentence, you can form an interrogative. We are going to see how can we do that. Let's start with the main part. Let's look at these questions. So I'm going to try to explain the first part of the chapter to you through two questions. These are two very easy questions, but I'll try to make you understand what is the difference in the two questions. Alright. Do you like tea? Okay, this is a very simple question. Do you like tea? If you like it or you don't like it. Next one is, what kind of tea do you like? Next question is a level up from the previous one. That is, what kind of tea do you like? Now let us see what is the difference in these two. Now for the first one, such questions can be answered with a simple yes or a simple no. Either you can say yes, I like tea. No, I don't like tea. It can be a very simple answer, either a yes or a no. Does not have to be very descriptive. Alright, let's see for the second one. Such questions cannot be answered with a simple yes or no. The answer must be a complete statement. For the second kind of question, what kind of tea do you like? Now try to understand. If somebody asks you, what kind of tea do you like? Will you say yes or no? No, you cannot say that. That will not answer the question. For this, you have to mention the kind of tea. Okay, like you like green tea or you like ginger tea or you like cardamom tea, all the different kinds of tea. So the answer has to be a complete statement. Suppose I say I like ginger tea. So this is a complete statement, a complete sentence. The answer cannot only be yes or no. So see how two questions can be so different. This I've taken from your book. Questions are often asked using what, when, where, which, who, whom, and why. Such questions that begin with WH. See, all of the spellings, they start with WH. Are thus referred to as WH questions. So because they start with WH, they are known as WH questions. To this list, we usually add how, since all of these are used to extract particular kinds of information. To this list of WH questions, we also add how. How does not exactly use WH in that sequence, but still, because there is a W and there is an H in the spelling of who, so we add who to this list as well. Why do we do so? Because all of these questions, they extract, they ask for some kind of an information. So this chapter is all about forming questions. So this was the very first thing that you need to know. Let's move on to the next part. Again, I'm going to look at some sentences to make this part clear to you. This is all taken from your book, so you can read your book as well after watching the video. It will give you a very clear picture of what I'm trying to explain. Okay, so here there's a sentence, she has left. What kind of a sentence is this? Please tell me. Answer, think about it for yourself. Try to answer it. This is a declarative sentence, okay, because they're giving out information about a girl that she has left, so it is declarative. Alright, now see, in declarative, what do? She is the subject, has is the helping verb, left is the main verb. So subject comes first, then comes the helping verb, then comes the main verb. Okay. She is the subject and has is the helping verb. This is how I've underlined. Okay. For subject, I have done a pink underline, and for helping verb, I have done a yellow circle. That's how I've just made it clear to you. When we change this into an interrogative sentence, the helping verb comes before the subject. Now, this is a declarative sentence. The chapter is about what? It's about formation of interrogatives. So, I'm going to teach you how to form an interrogative sentence from declarative. Now, children, you've already done this in class 5. The concept should be very clear in your head. So, this is just revision for you. There should be no point to feel stuck in this chapter. Okay? So, because she is the subject and has is the helping verb. In interrogative sentence, the order gets reversed. First, we write the helping verb, then we write the subject. Okay. So, how will we write? We will write, has she left? See, helping verb comes first, then comes the subject. Now, this sentence is an interrogative sentence. Did you understand? So, what did I teach you over here? That in a declarative sentence, subject comes first, then helping verb comes, then main verb comes. But when you change the declarative sentence into an interrogative sentence, first you will write the helping verb, then you will write the subject, and then the main verb. So, subject becomes like a sandwich between the helping verb and the main verb. Okay? That was the first rule. Now, this is... Let's take it as a fun activity, okay? I've given you a jumbled sentence. I've written, make, can, cookies, she. Does this make any sense? Make, can, cookies, she. It does not. I'm going to try to rearrange these words in two ways. And let's see what we can make out of it, alright? In the first way, I'm going to try to make this into a statement. Statement means a declarative sentence. So, I can simply say, she can make cookies. I rearranged the words and I made it, she can make cookies. Now, in the second way, I'm going to try to make it into a question. Question is an interrogative. Now, because I've already taught you in an interrogative sentence, first comes the helping verb, then comes the subject, then comes the main verb. So, you can write, can she make cookies? Can is your helping verb, she is the subject, make is the main verb. So, can she make cookies? See, the same words, you could rearrange the words to make it a statement as well, and you could also make a question. So, this is the first part of your chapter. This is very easy. The first part of the chapter is pretty easy. You all already know this. This is just a recap of what you've already done in your previous class. Based on this, in your book, there is an exercise which is on page number 9. This is how it looks like. So, here there are, in every sentence, there are some jumbled words given to you. You have to, out of those jumbled words, you have to make a declarative sentence and an interrogative. Just like we did with the cookie sentence, you have to make a declarative, that is a statement, and you also have to make an interrogative. The first one is over here done for you. It is an example statement for you. So here, the jumbled words are smoking, injurious, health is too. Okay, how can you make this into a declarative? You can say, smoking is injurious to health. How can you make this into an interrogative? Is smoking injurious to health? See, you've used the same words. You've just changed positions of the words and you have got two different kinds of sentences. That is exactly how you have to do the remaining sentences as well. I want you all to do this in your rough copy. You will not do this in any notebook or your textbook. You will not do it there. You will do it in rough. Because you are just learning it, I want you to do this in your rough copy. Read the rules till here. In the PDF that I will share, also watch the video. If you're getting stuck anywhere, watch the video once again. It will give you clarity, and then you do this exercise in your rough copy.